Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of Chassis Sim Technologies. And welcome to this latest episode of Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we have something very important to discuss. And that is, why simulation and data acquisition is your best friend. And with everything that's going on, ladies and gentlemen, in the motor racing community right now, this is a very, very important discussion that we need to have. First things first, particularly in the last 30 years, motor racing has always had a very Jekyll and Hyde relationship with technologies. So, for example, a classic case in point, the FIA's rather rash decision to ban underbody tunnels, and also for Formula One, and also the banning of active suspension. But also, too, on the flip side, you see some people extolling motorsport as showcases of technology. Yet, on the other side, you have a pervasive attitude that pretty much seeps underneath the surface of motor racing, that if it can't be fixed by a wrench and a hammer, then it's not worth fixing and it's all voodoo science. And ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you right now, that attitude is not just ill-founded, it's actually quite dangerous. And one of the great misconceptions of that's emerged in motor racing is that things like data acquisition and simulations, all they do is add cost. I can tell you right now, ladies and gentlemen, when it comes to leveling the playing field and helping you understand your race car, simulation and data acquisition are your very, very best friends. And this, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to be talking about in depth in this tutorial. So let's get started. First things first, I need to call out the elephant in the room and what inspired this tutorial in the first place. V8 Supercars have just decided to ban downloading data for the cars at the most recent race meeting at Eastern Creek. I've also heard that they're moving to ban tri-axis G meters. Now, supposedly this is done on the altar of cost cutting and to try and improve the show. Ladies and gentlemen, all this is doing is pandering to deeply ingrained prejudices in motor racing. And let me illustrate this with an example. One of the supercar commentators, who I will not name, claimed that, oh, well, with 500 maps, the average punter doesn't care about 500 maps channels. And on a superficial level, he's right. The average punter doesn't care about the fact that a data engineer can look at 500 maps channels. But I tell you what, that punter is much more interested in having the team that they barrack for or the racing brand that they barrack for, whether it be a Mustang, a Holden, or wherever it is, actually having a reasonable shot at achieving victory. And unlike that statement of 500 maps channels are too much, what we're about to discuss here is some very hard case studies about why data acquisition and simulation levels the playing field and is probably your most cost-effective way of doing it. And as we can see, that statement, that statement of, oh, the punters aren't interested in 500 maps channels has zero basis in fact. And let me say that again, ladies and gentlemen, zero basis in fact. Okay, why sim and data? Validating suspension geometry. Okay, from time to time, you're going to get a situation that looks like this. So what we've got here is that we've got actual versus simulated data. So what we've got is we've got speed, throttle, front dampers, rear dampers, lateral longitudinal G, and front pitch. Now, the rears aren't too bad. We look at the fronts. Now, most people, when they look at that, throw their hands in the air and just say, this is all crap. Data acquisition doesn't work. Simulation doesn't work. But what they're missing, ladies and gentlemen, is this is the simulator trying to tell you something. So when you see a situation like this, your best friend is to go to suspension geometry validation and do some hand calculations. And we are not talking rocket science here, ladies and gentlemen. Everything I'm about to discuss with you is high school level maths. And this can be done by a high school student or anyone with a calculator. So what we've got here is that when we have a situation like that, what we do is, one of the great things about chassis sim is it returns all the variables that drove this behavior in the first place. And now we've got the opportunity to look at them. So things like your front motion ratio, your spring rate, your braking force, your pitch centers, your rear pitch centers, your CG height, and your wheelbases. Now, what that does is that gives you the ability to hand calc what just went on there, so you can tie this back to what's going on. Now, in this particular case, what was happening here is that this calculated pitch from the simulator was actually correct. What that just showed you is there's something fundamentally going on with that car that you need to investigate it. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? And while I'm certainly not saying to you that you should never go to a K&C rig, quite to the contrary, I think going to a kinematic and compliance rig is one of the most valuable exercises you'll ever do. But when you're at the racetrack, when you see something like this, this tells you, hey, we got a problem and we need to sort this out. And again, what did that come from? The simple act of downloading a car, looking at the data, running a simulation, and comparing the two. Now, can someone tell me how that spoils the show when it gives a lower budget team the ability to look at this using their intelligence and their brains rather than their wallet? Moving on. Classifying tires. Now, the base tire model is your traction circle radius is your initial coefficient of friction, 1 minus KB times FZ, or multiplied by FZ. So, graphically, this can be viewed as the following. Now, the great thing is that when you've got a tri-axis G-meter plus damper sensors, that opens up the ability to reverse engineer this from data, and that's where the chassis sim tire force modeling toolbox comes in. And I just don't say this because I have a vested financial interest in you guys using this. I say this because this has saved my neck on more occasions than I care to remember. Here's a case in point. This is an example of the World Time Attack tire reverse engineered using the chassis sim tire force modeling toolbox. Now, let's put this in perspective, ladies and gentlemen. If you whack this on a rig, that's going to cost you USD 5K. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is wildly optimistic. Let me say that again. It is wildly optimistic. And let me tell you something. Most rigs that you'll put this on, the results that you'll get back, I'd have to say, and I say this from hard experience, that I'd have to say a good 90% of them are totally useless. But yet, using data and using a bit of simulation and using some intelligence and using nothing more than your time, you've got the ability to get that data. So what's the point of getting this data? Why are we bothering at all? Here's why. Using that data and using a base tire model of your traction circle radius versus load characteristics, you can now figure out how the stability index of the car varies with your front lateral load transfer, and how the total force varies with your front lateral load transfer. What does this tell you, ladies and gentlemen? This tells you that you can now set up your car using data and using fact, as opposed to just putting your finger in the air and just saying, I think the car should do this. Oh, I think if we add a little bit of front bar, I feel it might do that. Baloney, ladies and gentlemen. You want to achieve results? Quantify it. Get the numbers. It's as simple as that, ladies and gentlemen. And particularly that aversion that some aspects of motor racing has to saying numbers are the enemy is a complete and utter furphy. If I may paraphrase the school principal Joe Clark from the movie Lean On Me, that was actually based on a true story. When Joe Clark came into a school that had been completely run into the ground, he said to the teachers, discipline is not the enemy of enthusiasm. And the engineering byproduct of that is that quantification is not the enemy of the show. As we're going to soon discuss, it's actually its best friend. And it's one of the greatest misconceptions that have entered motor racing. And purely, all it's been done on is it has been founded by prejudice fueled by ignorance. Okay, why sim and data? Classifying aero. Right, listen to me very carefully here, ladies and gentlemen. Every time you run the car, every suspension pot you've got on the car, ladies and gentlemen, is a load cell. What can you do with that load cell? You can calculate the downforce. And this is a very simple example that I present, I get the attendees of the Chassis Sim Boot Camp to work through. No hocus pocus there, ladies and gentlemen. It's all very, very simple high school mathematics. So why bother doing this? Using what I've just shown you there, ladies and gentlemen, is the basis of how you figure out an aero map. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is a first generation A1GP aero map. Now, here's the thing that made this car unique. As you can see in the aero map, there was a very, very narrow band of the right-hand envelope where the car actually worked. I can tell you right now, ladies and gentlemen, this was the reason that A1GP Team China punched well above its weight with the first generation A1GP car. That and being able to reverse engineer the tire model from data was the two reasons we looked that we were so competitive. But there's a flip side to this story, ladies and gentlemen. It's also the reason that we weren't competitive in the second generation A1GP car. And here's why. In that second generation A1GP car, there was no damper pots. The tri-axis G meters didn't work properly. And the cars didn't have the adjustability. So consequently, the miracles that we could perform with the A1GP data to get Team China to the point where it was very, very competitive, couldn't happen in that second season on the simple principle that we didn't have the data to look into this. Now, a lot of people love to contend that data and math channels are the reason that are the key reason that the upper teams have been entrenched in their positions. That is total nonsense, ladies and gentlemen. Absolutely and utter total nonsense. And what I've just shown you is a key reason why. Another key reason why, ladies and gentlemen, is World Time Attack Challenge. In particular, the NA Autosport Engineering entry in the Open Class in 2016. Here's an example of everything that we did of bringing this all together. Doing the tire models from data, doing the aero models from data, using Chassis Sim shaker rig analysis. This was the correlation, and Chassis Sim was used to call the changes. This allowed the car to go from P17 to P3. Now, in terms of, I can tell you exactly what was charged for this from a Chassis Sim perspective, ladies and gentlemen. It would have been approximately $2,000 to $3,000 Australian plus GST. Now, can someone tell me and give me a logical reason how this spoils the show? Again, to ram home that point, discipline is not the enemy of enthusiasm. And ladies and gentlemen, engineering analysis and engineering quantification is not what is destroying the show right now, ladies and gentlemen. They are actually a key enabling technology to get to level the playing field, to allow teams with lower budgets and with lower resources to punch well above their weight. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a fact. No ifs, ands, or buts. Now, the question needs to be asked, what do you need to log? Now, a very good example of what you need to log is what makes up the Chassis Sim monster file. And the reason I say this is that monster file, whether it be for the A1 car, whether it be for the Time Attack cars I've worked on, whether it be for supercars, etc., etc., they have been the bedrock of being able to allow those smaller teams to punch above their weights. And here's what you need. Track distance, RPM, lateral G, longitudinal G, front left damper, front right damper, rear left damper, right rear damper, steered angle, throttle, and speed. Now, can someone make the case to me about for what is effectively, say, for a supercar, what is effectively a $500,000 road car. Can someone make the logical case for me how approximately a 10 to 15K worth of data logging, properly fitted out and properly looked, actually kills the show, particularly given in light of what we've discussed here, what we've discussed here, and what we have discussed in here in terms of giving you that window into the car, behavior. This late, and forgive me if I'm being a little bit heated on this, but it's a but I hate to say it, ladies and gentlemen, this is something that is killing us right now. It is going to lead to our end. So let me now wrap things up. Takeaways and food for thought. Simulation and data are key enablers. And here's why. It helps you to classify your car in ways that you never thought were possible, and it does it in a very cost-effective manner. And the key thing, ladies and gentlemen, is when you use it properly and when you use it intelligently, it levels the playing field. And ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude on this note. The environment that motor racing finds itself in right now is an extremely difficult one. If anything, there are times with when I've got younger engineers who come up to me and ask me, should I do motor racing as a living? My stock standard answer is don't. And here's why, ladies and gentlemen, because of the challenging environment that we find ourselves in, if we are going to survive this, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to survive not by trying to dumb down the show and to try and take it back, try and take motor racing back to the hammer and carburetor era. You've only got to have a look at things like what's happening with EVs, self-driving vehicles, etc., etc. If we are to survive, technology is not our enemy. Technology is going to be our best friend. So let me conclude on that note, and I'll catch you in the next episode of Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner.